Smile is the name of a robotic healthcare system project currently developed by the DLR Institute of Robotics and Mechatronics. It is an ecosystem consisting of different robotic devices, such as the humanoid robot Justin and the wheelchair-based robot Eden. The robots can work autonomously, but can also be operated via remote or local control. This can be achieved via haptic interfaces, such as using the HUG system. Users could also access the systems via other control options, such as using a tablet interface. To supervise the robots and extend their capabilities in future applications, the research team develops a control center from where communication to robotic systems can be established. There are three different roles for medically or technically trained personnel. The medical assistant is the first point of contact. They are therefore in charge of interactions with the robot's clients in case of emergency situations or when functional problems occur. The telehealthcare assistant will be involved whenever a robot needs to be controlled remotely. They can use a tablet interface to command autonomous actions of the robot. Alternatively, they can use a haptic input device to directly control motions of the robots. The technical assistant observes the states of the robotic hardware and software and takes corrective actions where required. In the following scenario, a person uses a robotic system of type Eden to take a bottle out of the fridge. In this scenario, the robot has a technical problem and therefore the user contacts the control center. After talking to the client, the medical assistant informs the telehealthcare assistant about the required actions, the type of robot, and its environment. Upon activation by the client, the telehealthcare assistant uses the haptic interface to remotely control the robotic arm of the Eden system. Through force feedback, the telehealthcare assistant is able to feel the interactions of the robot with its environment. Meanwhile, the medical assistant receives an emergency call from another client. A wristband sensor of the client has indicated low blood oxygen and pulse of a person living alone. The medical assistant notifies a doctor and informs the client that help is on its way and that robot-aided diagnostics will be performed. Since medical support has priority over technical assistance, the Eden client is informed that the technical support via teleoperation has to be suspended as soon as a safe state is reached. To perform diagnostics in case of emergency, the telehealthcare assistant first uses a tablet interface to command the humanoid robot of type Justin to grasp a medical diagnostic device autonomously. In the meantime, the Eden client has regained control over her robot and continues to command the robot in manual control mode. Using haptic teleoperation, the telehealthcare assistant can safely apply the medical device and supervise the diagnostic procedure. Besides the blood pressure, also the client's heart sounds are measured using a digital stethoscope. Once diagnostic has been performed, the medical assistant informs the patient that they will stay in contact until the doctor arrives on site. The technical assistant analyzes the occurred functional problems of Eden and implements changes if necessary. Additionally, the technical assistant utilizes the data from the teleoperation to evaluate the motions of the robot. This way, they can identify and classify task sequences which can be generalized to new autonomous capabilities. We believe that telerobotics, as demonstrated in the Smile Control Center concept, can help accelerate the deployment of autonomous assistant robots.